We teased earlier Carly Aquilino in Macoubies. Carly, you did something that steamed this boy's veggies. Scott Reardon.
You're going to make me blush,
You
Justin.
Don't even know. You don't even know what you did.
I'm sure I'm going to remember once.
Oh, you're going to remember.
Mm-hmm. Carly.
It's on a little app we like to call the IG.
Instagram.
Okay. On the Instagram.
Okay.
Do you follow Scott?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, and
which A, by the way, thank you.
Do I not follow everybody? I follow your show for sure. On Twitter, at least.
Mm-hmm. Well, I posted something a few weeks back, and I'm scrolling through my feed.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
And I see A1 Carly Aquilino not only liked one of my photos, but commented on one of my photos.
Which one was it, Scott?
And it said, wait, hold on, let me get it right. L-M, what is it? How do you say it?
L-M.
Laughing my...
L-M-F-A-O.
L-M-F-A-O. And I was like, Carly Aquilino
But Scott, it wasn't just the photo that she commented on. It was the photo in particular from a pretty special part of our show.
Do you remember what it was?
Right. I'm looking at it right now.
Here it is.
Okay, wait. Before I see. Yes. You got a tattoo.
Uh-huh.
On your.
Say it.
Say it.
Can I say
yes.
it?
Yes.
Both of these nuts.
Yay. We got our balls tattooed.
He got one and I got one.
You both did?
Yes, we did.
What is it of?
A UFO.
A little spaceship.
We got a spaceship on our ball.
And you like rate it on a scale of 1 to 10.
The pain?
The pain.
10.
Pure 10.
And the art now. 10?
6.5, 7. Would you like to hear some audio of him getting that tattoo?
I would 1,000%. I want to know everything about it.
Roll it.
Ow!
All mined from the day.
That's really funny, and that's like shows what type of person I am that I've never commented on any photos,
except
and then I'm
that.
Commenting on that photo. I'm such a jerk.
Oh,
you know,
a jerk? Are you kidding me? That was almost like a social media cooling salve.
It made the tattoo feel better.
All day long, we have this throbbing, agonizing pain in our walnuts.
I can't imagine. What was the healing process like, you guys?
Not terrible.
Really?
I'll tell you what. Like, we had that live broadcast the next day for St. Patrick's Day, and everybody's like, how your balls feel? How your balls feel? And I was like, they feel totally fine.
Yeah, like, I can't totally even fine. Feel them anymore.
some like physician was there, or like an RN or something, and explained when you get tattoos or trauma to certain parts like eyes, lips, your junk, your beehole, mm-hmm. that your body knows that's an integral part of the body and will heal it quicker.
Wow.
But if you cut your arm or you cut your knee or you cut your elbow.
Right, your body's like, who cares?
We'll get to it when we get to
We'll get there. Okay. Right. We're worrying around the beehole right now.
Exactly. You're just like, oh my God, the hole got hurt. Everyone, all hands on deck. All hands on deck.
Oh, code brown.
Code red. Something's going on with the beehole. Would you like to hear a little audio of me?
Yes.
I got mine done. Yes. All right, here you go. This is...
Oh, God, it's so much worse.
And here's another. And one more.
It's hard to breathe when you got a needle in your nuts.
Sack!
Oh, God, the things we do. Our
Why
producer,
did you guys do it?
Rest in peace. Our producer.
He was trampled by elk.
Trampled by elk in a horrific accident.
It was bad.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it was really bad. And then they had sex with his corpse. The elk had sex with his corpse.
The lead buck mounted him.
It was bad.
Awful.
Listen, he had a UFO tattooed on his testicles.
Okay.
So in honor of him.
Keeping it in the tradition.
To honor his... legacy.
Yes.
We both got a UFO on our balls.
We did.
On air.
Right here. Yeah.
I just decided to keep a picture of him, though.
Yeah. You were like, I'm just going to think about
I thought that would suffice.
He has a picture on his desk. We have permanently mangled nuts.
Yeah, in hindsight, a picture might have been fine. It's a good point.
Right.
But what are you going to do?
Oh. Right. Yeah. That's really funny.
Yeah.
I love that you were like, I'm all set.
Yeah, I'm good.
I'm going to. just sit this one out.
I'll just remember him.
Right.
So now every time I go to the bathroom, I see just this horrible Gorbachev-style splotch
and
on the side.
And it's all healed.
It's all healed. Well, here's the issue, too. I mean, I take it at some point or another, you've come into contact with testicles in the name of science.
Right.
Awful. All right. Right? A great comedian, Aaron Jackson, has once said that if a penis is a burger, the balls are the coleslaw you didn't want. But no matter what you tell the waitress, you're getting the coleslaw.
You're getting
that coleslaw showing up. Well, they had to elongate the skin to do the tattoo. But now that they have returned to normal size.
Oh, wait, what does it look like? An ant?
Just a splotch of black and weird.
I mean, I will show you if you want to see it. I don't know if I'm allowed
see
to do that.
Everything. I
Carly
think.
Aquilino, do we have audio confirmation and consent that
I need
you would
it.
Like to
Otherwise,
see?
Otherwise, I might get arrested or fired.
Guys, I don't know the answer.
We'll give you a minute.
I'm like, I want to see it. I think I want to see it.
I can maybe meet you halfway and show you a picture of it. So I don't have to withdraw
I'll just go full
my
Monty for you.
Smelly Kraken. If we could, by the way, Justine.
I mean, like 2 weeks after.
Get the camera off of us,
if
Justine.
If I had a dollar for every person that saw my balls like 2 weeks after that.
80%
oh,
women,
just,
by the way.
You don't even care about them anymore. You're like,
was,
I don't even.
Yeah, people were like, can I? I was like, all right, sure. You can all see right. it.
And guys, the yes. whole thing is very interesting to Please. Me.
What is? Explain.
The fact that you went through that pain. I can't
it's for
imagine.
Our brother. We love him.
It's a dedication yeah. to our fallen brother.
Wow.
If something befalls you, and so help me God.
So help you God.
If something
now you've
does,
wished it on me.
I will burn this world to ash if anything ever happens to Carly. I would do some sort of memoriam, like a huge C
okay.
on my face, and he'd get an A, and he'd get
do
an
you guys
early.
Have any other tattoos?
We each have some tattoos. Yes. Josh is a good, faithful Jewish boy. He's not going to desecrate
you.
His body.
Right.
But we have some tats yourself?
I have a bunch.
Really?
Yeah.
What was the? Where's the one in the most like or painful spot?
The inside of my arm was pretty bad. Mm-hmm. That spot, like,
he's got those too, Scott.
That's like the worst. They suck.
Nah,
getting
the balls
that done.
Are worse.
The, balls
oh
are
yeah,
worse.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
Balls are pretty bad.
That I'll never feel. That'll never know how bad that feels.
It's well here. That's pretty much it, right there. It was the worst thing I've ever been through.
Yeah.
So, have you thought about it?
I think if she has to think this long, it's
guys,
it's
I don't
no.
know.
What is? What
I
is
think
your,
it might scare me more than I'm already scared.
All right.
Of balls.
They're disgusting.
They're so scary.
Really?
And then with art on them.
With a logo.
You guys know I love art.
I know you love
you know
art. I'm so torn. Love art, hate balls. Where do I go?
It's your mixing. It's like, you know, you're mixing a great thing with a really scary thing.
Can I make you hate them even more with a fun science fact?
No, no.
Balls?
Yeah.
What is it?
Do you know? And the next time you are with gentlemen that you are with lover.
Okay.
You're going to do a little science.
Okay.
Do you know that male testicles
oh God.
Never stop moving.
Stop it.
Scott, Josh, I ask you, do a little R&D tonight, emphasis
do it
on
right
the
now.
Day.
What do you mean? Is
Place
that real
them?
Science or is that just your balls?
Someone showed me once.
Someone showed you their balls?
Some what? Trucker.
Did you just look at your own?
Hey boy, come check this out. If you place yourself on a
okay.
flat surface, hands up and let them sit.
Okay.
You'll see them begin to settle the
right.
way they do because
yeah.
it's very mushy-ish.
The whole thing scares me.
But then you will see them undulate.
Really?
Like a curious jellyfish lurking across the landscape.
Why?
Okay. And then they never settle.
They never settle. They will constantly
be moving. And is there a reason why?
I don't know.
Yeah, that's what I said. Why?
There has to be a scientific
that's
reason
one of
why.
Those reason, it's one of those mysteries of the universe I don't want to know. I just like to know that my bees are sentient.
Yeah.
They just sort of move.
I mean, they're working 24 hours a day.
They're
overtime.
All the
you
time.
You know, you're sleeping, your balls are moving.
All right. day, every day. They're horrible. If I could find a way to get them
now
surgically
really
removed,
balls.
surgically remove, but have everything else function as is.
I mean, the whole thing is very confusing to women, just FYI. Oh, and I can't speak for all women, but I think the majority of us are very confused at how that whole operation goes down.
Do we tell her about the guy that came in yesterday?
What guy?
Are we screwing with her whole week?
Was that yesterday or the day before?
I actually had a rough month or so.
I went home and I sat down on the couch and I'm like, and I'm just watching like whatever reality TV. And it's just a normal day. And I'm like, oh, I got to get my daughter from school at like 3 o'clock. And then for whatever reason, the memory of what happened that morning flashed into my head and went,
what
this
happened?
This morning I saw something. And then I just go about my day like it's just a normal day. Like, we have the weirdest existence.
We did a break about getting plastic surgery.
And
a guy got plastic surgery, and he was medicinally had to. He got chemo, and it fried his junk up.
Oh, wow.
His meat and two veg just got cooked with radiation. Right. So to repair it, they placed two air bladders inside of it.
Well, it's not air. It's like saline.
Saline solution, fillable, inflatable bladders inside of his mailbag.
Really?
They placed
his
mailbag.
They placed he worked for USPS.
Yes. Mail, M-A-L-E, bag. They placed in between his testicles a pump.
A pump.
No.
That when it's go time, he goes...
Wait, and it actually works.
It pumps up his penis.
That's kind of amazing.
Saw it.
And he came in here.
In person.
He brought it in.
He stood right here and dropped his pants and did it for... He pumped up his penis for us.
I couldn't handle it. He deflated it, reinflated it.
And then I just went to Panera. Like, it was not...
Yeah. I'll have the bread bowl and can I get the apple instead of the chips? By the way, I saw a guy inflate his hog earlier.
What? Does he feel it?
Yo, everything
what
works.
Do you mean feel?
When he does have sex?
Everything's fine.
Everything's fine. He just couldn't keep an erection.
Where is the accessory?
It's inside.
It's inside his.
You can't even see it.
Oh, the like pump guys is don't in... touch their balls enough. They had to put a pump in there for this guy.
He's got it.
It's a 20 pump night, baby.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.